I'll call and tell you you got a good one. That work okay?
It is 10 minutes till 1, and this is the Community Services Committee meeting. The Open Meetings Act is on the wall over here. If we can go around and introduce ourselves, I'm Mark Kraft, Douglas County Board of Commissioners.
E.J. Morgan, County Board.
Catherine Hall, County Administration.
Patrick Bloomingdale, Swiss Creek, Florida Duda, County Board.
Kent Holman, Environmental Services.
Constance Myrendorf, Douglas County Clerk's Office.
Marion Borgeson, County Board.
Chris Tuckler.
Scott Olander.
Diane Carlson with County Administration.
Jill Lorenz, County Finance Director.
And I've been asked to put one more thing on the agenda under other business, and that's Kent Holm has something he wants to say. How long are you going to take, Kent?
It's just a short informational item.
I thought your retirement wasn't until next week.
Well,
I'm going to let
I had a bad vision about that, like, earlier today.
So, Ken?
The only item I had was the City of Omaha is doing a trail extension that will hook up the Turner Boulevard Trail to the Field Club Trail. Their proposed path is along the south side of Pacific Street, and it's between like 36th and the Field Club Trail. There's a section adjacent to the Field Club Golf Course from about 38th Street over to the Field Club Trail where sometime back in the past there was right-of-way that didn't get granted to the city as part of the street. So there's a piece of land that we're recommending the county donate to the city for that right-of-way piece, and that allows us to kind of get out of the way of that trail. It negates any maintenance responsibilities that we would have, and we basically, in consultation with the county attorney's office, it would be a quit claim deed, and all we're waiting for is just a letter from the city indicating that they would be willing to accept that. So I just wanted that to be in front of the board. That'll come before the county board as soon as we can get that all squared away with the deed and the appropriate documentation. So that's all I had. I just wanted to inform the board.
Okay. Now we'll enter into the Douglas County Fair Board discussion.
Thanks, Kip.
Mm-hmm.
And
thanks.
Trying to figure out, we're getting rid of the department, and we don't have an administrator for that department anymore. We are trying to decide, do we need the fair board along with the 501c3? Will there be a need for it? So we're going to have this discussion here about, is there a need for the fair board? If we feel there is a need, what will they do? And if we feel there isn't a need, what will happen to the county fair?
Great, thanks.
So I'm going to open up the floor for discussion. Mary Ann?
As fair board members, I'd kind of like to hear what your opinion is on this. If you have one, if not, fine. I just don't know if you guys had a conversation and have a ask of us or not.
I just came to listen.
Sorry.
No. We kind of polled our fair board members in light of everything that was going on, and I think, you know, we were, with all the events that have passed before, we were kind of blindsided as well as everybody else. As a group, we're volunteers or whatever. I honestly think that the fair has its place in Douglas County. I just got back from a convention from 5 states and county fairs and stuff, and the county fair seems to be the focus point of a lot of these counties in Illinois and Kansas, and population doesn't seem to be the size. And I think the Douglas County Fair can be or should be the common denominator between rural Douglas County and urban Douglas County, meaning city of Omaha and stuff. And we went through the process, had it at the Crossroads Mall, and we got a lot of input and feedback. And it surprised us because people want to see dirt, they want to see animals, they want to see livestock. One of the things that we've been in the process was the idea that we don't have a lot of residents of Douglas County that have livestock. And so we've been working with a few people to have a progress show. And as our last meeting from the university, Monty Stauffer has been working on this with other people in the area, and he says we're going to have 60 head of cattle. Well, wow. That's more cows in the county. And so, I mean, there is a definite need. I think the location, I just think it's a great community event. Nothing else. It promotes family and family values. And so,
but in terms of, you have a 501c3 now, and then we still have this fair board. And so the question that we're asked is, do we keep the fair board or do we do away with the fair board and only let the 501c3 do their thing?
Okay.
Most of our board members are keep the fair board because we like working with the county and having like legal support like that.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
The idea of the 501c3 was, and I think there was some confusion possibly, that they went after a domain name very on and it didn't come into existence until last fall. And the problem was is because, to my understanding, that going out and soliciting funds to support it, a lot of companies just want to give to a 501c3, and then with the county being a public entity, it's a question. So dealing with it, say the IRS or whatever, then they would have to deal with it. They just want it clean and simple, and that was the whole idea behind that.
And that's very true. I mean, two of our departments that we sit on their foundation board. So I sit on the Community Mental Health Foundation board, and it was for exactly what you just said, that we sit as the board of trustees, but in order to go out and garner private support, they want to give to a 501c3. So we formed these foundations for the Community Mental Health Center and for long-term care. So we actually have a board and then a 501c3 that has separate people. Common denominator, maybe a commissioner or two that sit on these foundations, but they're different people. And so our discussion under Commissioner Kraft's committee here is, do we agree to keep the fair board intact, or do we just let it go and let the 501c3 do everything? And so I'm not speaking for anybody else, but my opinion would be what you just said, is keep it as the fair board and then still structure your 501c3 as kind of a foundation type body that Mark can sit on, actually, as a liaison, if you will, for us between the two boards.
I'm not committing to anything.
No.
Personally, I'm fine with that.
Yeah. So. I mean, it doesn't have to be you. I'm just saying, because you're the chair of it, if you wanted to do that, then that I would be okay with that.
Sure.
Does it pay?
Oh. No, sorry. No.
Okay. Claire, you look like you wanted to say something.
No, I agree with Commissioner Morrison. I mean, I think the 501c is the most appropriate way to move forward with the hotel motel tax dollars that you receive. You got to have that 501c in place to be more appropriate. And it may not be the same board as the fair board. I mean, you may have some different people, some overlap, but it's there to...
That would be good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, assuming that you're going to move forward...
Ask Mark to speak.
No. I'm sorry, Mark can speak.
I'm not 100% today.
Oh, okay. Patrick, I'll help you out. Patrick.
So,
can I let you leave the meeting?
Sure.
So,
absolutely.
Commissioner Boyle's going to be on the fair board. That's the first thing we know.
What'd you just say?
We just made our first appointment to the fair board.
Oh, Lord. Hurry up, adjourn before any decisions, other decisions are made.
assuming that we're going to go forward as is with the fair board, we'll still need to get some idea then going forward on what your plans are going to be for how things are going to work going forward. Are you going to have, because we're not going to have a county employee providing you the support, although you can still rely on the county attorney, I guess, mm-hmm. for advice, but you're not going to have a Rita type person who's a county employee. And then the whole timing of when the fair is versus when the, because you will have to apply as a 501c3 for visitors promotional council funds, which you've never done before. And there's a whole application process. The application will be coming out soon. But then the timing of when that is versus when the fair is, this is all going to be new to you. So that's all going to have to be worked through. Yeah.
Commissioner Morgan?
I was going to ask if you have a long commitment at Crossroads, like 3 years or something, to be there. That concerns me a little bit because I know that soon after, I think, the election, city election, they may be starting monumental kind of projects there.
Crossroads was a one-year deal.
Yeah.
We knew that going in, and we've been looking at Chance Ridge. That's where we held the high school rodeo.
Oh, okay. Yep.
And another place.
Where is that, like out on the other side of
Dodge Street?
Out there?
Yeah.
On the other side of Metro's Elkhorn campus?
Yeah. The next exit would be Skyline Drive, and that would be.
And it's just right off the exit. It's real convenient.
Another Elkhorn Equestrian Center approached us about having. Hosting the fair.
Okay. Really?
We looked at that location. One of the things that concerned Chris and Shane and I went out there and looked at it. One, if it's weather, they have the indoor arena, and there didn't seem like I had a whole lot of covered area, but they're wanting to develop that into kind of an event center, but they didn't have the building space to cover. And the other thing is that, you know, we have to think about is emergency plans. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if there's like a thunderstorm or whatever, and, you know, they have an 8-1. Mm-hmm. And I learned that at the convention. But basically, you know, who to get involved with the weather station and the sheriff's department, whatever. And you can do if they have a deal where the weather station will notify us if there's a lightning strike within 8 miles. And then we start mm-hmm. dismantling and getting people out and undercover or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so so for those, to factor in those needs or whatever, evacuation or whatever, right now it looks like Chance Ridge is, and then with the rodeo, he was a big sponsor last year to help out with the rodeo, so.
Commissioner Kraft and Commissioner Dieter.
Where is this other equestrian
center? Equestrian center?
It would be north. It'd be southwest of a 204th and Highway 31, or Bennington Road. Okay. I guess that would be it.
Mm-hmm.
Old Bennington Road.
Commissioner Duda,
how does it compare to Chance Ridge? I thought Chance Ridge was a great facility. I'm not familiar with the Elkhorn Equine Center.
Well, it's we're trying to deal with like submit bids or different options.
Okay.
So we're not just saying, well, we're going to have it here or whatever, just to kind of keep things.
How far is it from Chance Ridge? Any chance that you could utilize both locations?
It's about 6 miles north.
Never mind.
Now, if we ran out of space at Chance Ridge, we were looking at possibly, there's been talk about having a horse show with all the different groups, disciplines, and breeds in the area, and going to like Skyline Ranches. And the other thing is, if for like parking, we kind of like Chance Ridge, the idea that we could use Elkhorn High School. They've talked to them about for parking, and Metro Community College, and possibly a shuttle if we ran out of space.
Nice.
So
sounds good. Thank you.
So did I know we can't make a decision in here, but from what I'm hearing is that we kind of keep the fair board intact. We let them do the 501c3, or they have the 501c3. That would be the entity that goes after the LB262 funds. And then timing wise, I think that's some of the stuff that you guys have to kind of talk about, because that application process is going to be starting tomorrow?
Probably tomorrow or Thursday.
Thursday, yeah.
If we decide to keep the fair board, We don't have to do anything. We don't take it to the county board.
No.
But we do have a problem with meeting the state guidelines as far as appointments. We have too many people from Omaha compared to the outlying areas.
Really? We haven't appointed them properly?
No.
Not sure.
I wasn't aware of that.
Neither was I.
Where'd that come
from? In the past, we haven't. That was
I thought we just did.
Right, appointing them.
So our, well, I remember, as it stands today, are you guys appointed appropriately or not?
I think so, because the statute says cities, towns, villages, or precincts, or townships.
Okay.
So there's multiple different options of that.
So right now, there's a disproportionate share of appointees from the city of Omaha.
Okay.
But
this is something Shaquille had brought to light, I think, maybe last
yes.
year.
But if it's
right.
precincts,
but
you could say it's voting
saying.
Precincts, and there's like a couple hundred of those.
Maybe just as a recommendation, we maybe get the Fair Board members out to everybody and when their terms are and where they're from, and then see how off we are on
yes,
the...
I hate to break apart this Fair Board.
I know.
Oh, I have no intention.
Is there any reason to?
I have no intention.
I would say leave it alone.
Uh-huh.
I mean,
if
this
we're
is
fought,
a,
if we're
once
not...
Once again, this is a problem in search of solutions. I would say leave
uh-huh.
it unless there's a...
Unless
to.
We're out of guide.
Well,
unless we're not within the statute.
And who's going
to Shaq, according to Shaq, and I would just say this, I've had some disagreements with all due respect to Shaq on some issues, particularly as it relates to the health center, interpreting statutes in specific ways. So I guess I would like Diane and I to have a look at the statute to see, because you just mentioned if it's precincts, you're not.
Yeah, there's like
compliance.
Three different ways.
If there's three different ways to look at it, I want to make sure that it's being looked at in a way that's
okay.
beneficial to us, but we're still legally within compliance.
Okay. So.
Catherine?
Just for the status quo, since Shaquille identified this, everyone was essentially, who was on the board was on the Fair Board, and then when someone didn't want to be reappointed, we worked that in and paid attention that when the next person was appointed to find someone from a specific outside of City of Omaha.
Yeah.
So that's what we had been doing, was no changes to the current makeup. If someone didn't want to be reappointed, then that's
yep.
how we paid attention to it that
well,
way.
Okay,
that
right now, we
to.
Have three board members that live outside
no,
the city limits. And if I change my address from town to the farm, you got four board members outside of the city limits. So that's out of nine, that's, you know, not quite half.
I don't have, I guess, I'm just, Commissioner Kraft brought it up to make sure we're within the law of it, and I know we just appointed the two from outside
York
the
city.
City.
Yep.
So, you know, just, I, for one, would like to know who they are and where they're from, as
Scott
we're
Brune,
appointing
those.
Them.
Scott Brune and then
Margaret.
Margaret.
Margaret, and they live in outside Elk City.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then... Rob Vinson, the treasurer, he's outside the city limits. He's up there by Deer Creek.
Or is Lindsay Golden, where's she living?
Well, that's another one. Yeah,
she's,
five.
She's in her mom's house, isn't she?
Yeah.
So she's
grandpa,
outside the city.
At grandpa's.
Yeah, she's a neighbor.
So
well,
we've got
again,
five.
If we could just get the names and their terms and where they're from, what area, you know, I think we'll be good.
I think we had that before.
Go.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I agree. I have no intention of
no.
removing any board members. It's simply when a vacancy occurs, if we should be giving priority to somebody that lives
right.
in a certain area, that's all I'm looking for.
Sure. So I really don't know what else Commissioner Kraft had on the agenda other than that discussion. And we don't really have to take anything. So unless you guys have something else you want to chat about, I would say we're... done.
It's a new one.
Staff, do you have anything else on this that you want to talk about? Do we want to go over the 262 so they completely understand what is
well, we
needed?
Have a,
who's a good grant writer?
We have a board member who is a grant writer.
Oh, you have a board member
yeah.
that is? Okay.
Yeah.
That's what I need right now.
But I do have a...
Okay.
How do you want us to handle when we do get sponsorship money?
It goes
like
through 501.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Not us 501.
It's your business. I mean, it's your...
Well, for the fair board.
We're arm's length? No.
Yeah,
well,
501c3.
That's 501c3. That's kind of speaks to a point Diane has referenced before, is do if there's going to be arrangements similar to Exarban functioning as a nonprofit and the fair board sort of separate but working together to do the fair, do we need to develop some kind of agreement outlining that relationship between the fair board and the nonprofit association?
Commissioner Rogers?
I think if you're going to do that in the 262 process where you have that contract between entities, your money should go to the 501c3, and that separates us out of it totally. And the 501c3 board would be actually negotiating what to do with the money you get.
I think more people would want their funds to flow through the 501c3 yeah. anyway than right. the county, so sure. I think whatever funds you get,
you come through here, it's a whole other level mm-hmm. of scrutiny.
Yeah, but there's better accountability, and I have no problem with accountability.
But we're not going to track. We're not dealing with any funds. We're not going to have our accountants deal with the funds. We're out of it.
Okay.
So you probably should get a board member that is an accountant. Commissioner Kraft?
I was so pleased with the results and momentum of the high school championship rodeo that if you have to forego county fair this year, I don't think anybody's going to have a major emotional breakdown, let's put it that way. Nobody's going to, most people won't even notice we're not doing it. But I think we should pursue the high school rodeo because that does a tremendous amount of county recognition. Bringing people in, youth participation, and many of the other things that we, you know, the extension tie-in, et cetera. Now, since I missed some, you may have talked about it, having the county fair at the same time as the rodeo. And I realize that maybe after the state fair, but we were always after the state fair when it started happening. So that's something you need to consider too.
Okay, now to address that, when it was after the state fair, there was a lot of questions about whether they, you know, the residents of Douglas County could qualify for the state fair. Mm-hmm. And that was the idea, because now it's like Sarpy, you have to be a resident of Sarpy County to exhibit at Sarpy County Fair, unless you're a 4-H kid, but other than that. So it's hard for them to qualify, and this is why, you know, the last year we were downtown, we had 9 quilts, and then last year we had 164. And we had 4 more quilts than what they had on display at Grand Island, just FYI. And so, but that's the drawing card. And that's what we got to look for is, you know, we want to be unique enough not to compete with other counties. And so.
Are you still pursuing the robotics? I don't remember who.
I remember that conversation with how it went with the groups that were doing that. Mm-hmm. There's basically infighting between them, and they don't work well together.
Imagine
basically
that.
So nobody could agree on anything.
I think the idea that we're kind of, what we want to do is, okay, with the fair board, you know, to stay the momentum and keep everybody motivated and whatever, is we cannot do everything. And one of the things was we went out and we found 2 quilt ladies, Chris and I found her down there and said, what would you do to make it different? We had another deal with a guy who wanted to have a rabbit show, came to the meeting, presented it, told him to think big, and what do we have, 500 rabbits?
Yeah, and to let you know about the rabbits, you only started out with 10.
But it's things like that, it's just basically, you know, where people come forward with ideas to, one of the things that's kind of caught on, we'll see what's happening, is our new board member, Scott Brune, you know, he came to the fair and he says, well, where's the dirt, where's this or whatever, and he said, you know, do something. Well, he's going down history lane about what's going on. Well, now he's working on a deal with some of the local church groups out in western Douglas County about recreating memory lane of what the fair was like in the good old days.
Nice.
So the idea is that we want to engage more people, whatever. The high school rodeo, we've been talking in light of everything. The group that, it sounds too, well, rumor has it there's not going to be a rodeo in downtown this year. Okay, that's rumor. So anything I say is for entertainment purposes.
You're talking about service?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And the stock show went to Grand Island and this stuff. So a lot of the people that were part of that have, a couple have come forward to volunteer to, you know, manage the rodeo. And along with that, you know, there's well-connected sponsorship. We had talk about having a rodeo school. And so whether or not that's going to be, you know, for a couple days, events or whatever. And then there's the, I don't know, I would like to have it. It's the Rough and Ready Rodeo. And that's mm-hmm. for the challenged kids that come and they get mm-hmm. to do this stuff. It was a big deal. And so right now it doesn't have a home. And hopefully, you know, that we can secure that. But and plus we have our trail challenge coming up here at the end of April. And that pretty much pays for itself. So,
too bad they didn't have, you know, that muffin, mutton stuffing, the little kids on the...
Yeah.
What's it called?
Mutton busting.
Mutton busting. Mutton. Mutton. Yes. That. Too bad they didn't have one, like, for oversized ones, and then we could have it against the commissioners. That would be, like, really fun.
Or just the chairperson.
No.
Well, the dunking tank, I tried to volunteer.
I know, but I was gone. It's always during the annual meeting.
Yeah, I know, so it was
like, yeah.
I would have volunteered.
I would have, too. I've been in as long as you stayed away.
But back to our deal, the idea was if we get people that want something or have a passion to do it, we just want to, you know, help them achieve their goals
sure.
for the fair.
Make it happen.
Sure.
Yeah. That's great.
How long is your term on the board?
Counting the day, I don't know, but I got a year and a half left, 2 years.
I think end of 18.
Are okay. they 4 year term office?
Three year.
Okay.
Well, it's lucky to have you.
Yes.
Your enthusiasm.
You guys are wonderful.
Commitment's great.
Absolutely.
Really.
Well, I'm just doing all this so somebody will say something nice about me at my funeral.
I'll volunteer my boil.
Okay, well, I guess this was the only item on in...
No, I think it's good. I think okay. you're moving in a good direction, and that sounds really good.
And I want to work
I like your enthusiasm.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
More on that partnership with Randy Schmausel from
Yep, you're doing a lot of the right things.
Yeah.
Absolutely, I'm excited.
So where do I find a good grant writer?
Do you have one on your board?
So.
Who?
Okay.
Now.
She's going to be busy till...
Who are you talking?
Sarah Weiss.
Oh, sure.
She's,
oh.
Been, she's with the oh. International... She's doing the International Horse Show right now.
Okay.
And so...
Yeah. I forgot she was on there. Oh, she's, yeah.
She's rather busy.
Uh-huh. Sure.
Well, you can look at past parts of the applications that were submitted in past that had to do with the fair and at least get an idea
yeah.
of what the ask was. And now you have lots of new stuff to add to it.
Townships.
Okay.
Nope.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Great.
Friday.
Nice.
Friday.